It's Matt speaks you back here once again with more content for you guys today. I just kind of woke up from a nap, as you guys can see from the unmade bed. So we're just gonna get into this video. So as you guys can see from the title, and maybe possibly if I made a thumbnail for this video, as you guys can see from the title, today we're gonna be talking about drama. Yes, drama. I'm Matt speaks you talks. So I wanted to talk about this. I've been watching a lot of animation videos. Concerning the fact of no crushes and drama or story time videos, you can say. And one of my favorite YouTubers I'm subscribed to, he does a lot of story time videos and he tells his experiences. And a lot of them, I don't know if you would classify them as drama, but what I understand, it's a situation that people get themselves into or a bad situation because multiple reasons. So I just want to talk about that quick today. So if you guys do enjoy this video, if you guys do agree, make sure to leave a like down below and subscribe to do all that crazy stuff, become a mini Pichu today. So anyways, you guys noticed, let me ask you guys, have you guys ever got into drama or a situation that A, you didn't put yourself in, B, you didn't need to put yourself in, C, possibly bad situation that can be bad for you in the end? Or D, all the above. Have you ever been in one of those situations? I know I have. I'm pretty sure most people in their lives go through situations like such as I just said. Most drama or most situations that make people uncomfortable really are just people. I feel like most times I see drama on YouTube, when I see drama in real life, I see situations that can be classified as drama. I see people either just like completely doing something that they shouldn't be doing in the first place, like they know they shouldn't be doing, or they just do it for the satisfaction of themselves, or somebody just being completely messy and not regarding other people's time and privacy. A lot of drama that I see, it's, you know, I don't know if this is a study at all, but if you guys ever got yourself into a situation, I know a lot of times I see is when people tell their business. Like, one person I know, they just got their business leaked all over the place. Like, you know, especially when you're in school, this is a lot more apparent. But if you're, like, in a smaller community, you know what I'm talking about, where it's something says something about you and a whole word just gets spread out. So, I feel like that's really, really apparent, you know. So, that's how I'm getting my information out, first of all, my personal life. And you just don't do that in general. So, I notice a lot of the time that, like, a lot of time, we like, say, like, yeah, like, a group of 10 people, 1 out of 10 of those people are going to be a gossiper. And a gossiper is the main fueler to drama and arguments and stuff like that. Because those people are the ones who support sides. Basically, they make the fire. Sometimes people don't try to, but maybe somebody will overhear gossiping and it just gets all around. And everybody will know. Then they get back to the person who actually, you know, who the person that's getting gossiped about, so it just all becomes one big storm. But there's always that one person, that one messy person that's always there trying to go all around to get somebody's information. Like, I remember a study or something, like it was like a Boondocks or something. There's always gonna be that 1 out of 10 dude who's gonna call the police. And I'm like, there's always that 1 out of 10 person who is going to who is a gossiper, who is gonna get your word around. There's always that one messy person there. And I can name a few people on the top of my head from my school. I'm not going to do that, obviously. But, like, be aware of those people, guys. Those people don't really care about your time, your effort, your privacy. They don't care. They only care for the satisfaction of themselves. And because maybe talking about other people makes them feel good. I don't really understand drama and gossip. Like, because they go together like a big bundle. I don't really understand. Like, why would you want to talk about somebody else's life? Talk about your own life. I'm just saying. I don't have other people's lives I'll talk about is my brother and my sisters, my mom, because they've been with me my entire life. So, they're my family. So, and also, I always notice, if anybody else notices this, there's always two types, like, a couple of types of people in our drama. Like I said, one person that just makes the fire, makes the problem, keeps feeling the problem, might keep gossiping, or keep doing something to keep feeling the problem. You got that one bystander that is just on the side and didn't do anything, but somehow got dragged into the problem. You got the two people arguing, or the two people that had the predicament with. So, you know, there's always certain situations, always a couple of people, but a way to avoid these types of problems and stuff, and I feel like a really easy way to, is just don't talk about other people. If you have comments, keep them to yourself. You know, this video may seem kind of weak because I don't have my thoughts together, but trust me, guys. When you think you guys can trust somebody, be sure who you can trust. Because, like, I know one of my greatest friends in the world, Stupid Tails, you know, yeah. Like, I know I could probably trust him because, like, we've been really good friends for a long time. But, no, you can't be going all willy-nilly for everybody else in the world. So, all I'm saying is, be careful who you talk around, because you can, I don't know, your information getting around. And also, one thing I noticed about Gama and gossip, drama and gossip. You know how they come together? I always notice, okay, guys, I'll be right back, sorry. Anyway, sorry, there was some alarm going off, it was really annoying. Like I said, there's always that one person out of the crowd, and I notice every single time, like, have you guys ever noticed this before? Like, when you're, like, in a school setting or a work setting or something like that, you have the gossipers, you know, the gossip isn't a horrible thing, but when it gets around to the point where it gets all, it spreads quickly and really, really rapidly, when it gets back to the person that was about in a day, you know, I've seen that happen before, and I still will never understand why people just completely disregard other people's time and their patience and everything about their character just to go ahead and talk crap about them behind their back and spread stuff about them, which they know they don't want to. I mean, those people even have a soul. I'm sorry, it's kind of a douchebag thing to do. I would never do it. I don't really gossip and talk about people unless it's my friend. I know they need help, so that's like the only situation. But even if you're like sending other people's information around, that's still not good. Unless you're talking directly to that person about whatever problem they have, that's good because you're helping them with it. But at the same time, you can't just go take somebody's information that's not yours and just go throw it somewhere else and like it was yours because it's not. And I feel like that's a lot of people. A lot of people get into drama because, they get mad at each other. And I feel like when people get mad at each other, they say some pretty crazy things because the brain isn't working right. You know, when you're mad, you're clouded, your decisions are clouded, so what you're going to be saying is going to be pretty messed up or pretty clouded. So when you're angry at somebody, you're not going to completely be thinking straight. So you might say something that you might regret, or you might think later, wow, I was an idiot for saying that, because that's just how the brain works, and the brain, it doesn't function right when you're mad, because it just completely filled by hatred at the moment. So I feel like a lot of moments when I see people like get into drama with each other is for like one, ignorance is a big part of drama. When somebody says something about somebody that is completely not true, and why would you, I'm questioning people, why would you care about something if you know it's not true, but whatever. But a lot of people, ignorance, it is out of pure ignorance, say something, and it starts a whole controversy over it, which I would never understand myself. This not knowing what you're talking about a lot of times can be really, really, really bad. It can just make a whole situation, when you feel what you're talking about, it can just make the whole situation even worse. Because, say, you think you overhear something, so you tell another person, then you just have a whole lies going around whatever community that you're in. Which, things spread hecka fast. I just want to talk about gossip real quick, and maybe wrap this video up. Gossip. So I know people make code names for each other, which is, like, crazy that people, like, do you actually care about this person enough to make a code name for them? I don't care about nobody. I do care about a lot of people, but I'm not going to waste my time and make a code name about the person and talk about them. It just doesn't make sense to me. So, let me see. Yeah, I never understood. Sorry, I just hit the stop button just in time. So anyways, I was talking about, Oh yeah, just making code names. If you care about somebody that much, that you have to make a code name about them and talk about them that much, it's kind of bad. Like, why do you do that? It doesn't make any sense. I'm gonna get off of drama for a little bit, because drama's kind of stupid in my opinion. And I feel like the one main reason about drama why it happens so much. Humans love drama. I'm gonna say that. Humans love it. Hey, you. I know most people, at least a good percentage of people watch drama shows. You know, those MTV shows, those crazy Atlanta shows, you know, those types of shows. People love watching those shows. People love conflict. And that's where we get a lot of problems in the world, because people see it, they like it, they want to keep it the same way. But really, conflict is only one part of life that we can't keep going forever. So some people just keep trying to search for that conflict and keep on trying to do it and do it and do it. And life just doesn't work like that. Like, you can't have the same type of conflict all the time. So making things unbalanced and making things messy, that's how people's life becomes like that. Also, the thing I hate about gossip is how inconsistent it can be sometimes. Like, sometimes, like, you hope it doesn't spread too fast. It's like wildfire. It spreads everywhere, depending on how big the word is. I feel like this is more, I don't know. I feel like, as of right now, I feel like it's really apparent in, like middle schools and pre-K and, I don't know, schools and communities in general. Like, people are really nosy, right? People are drama, right? Nosy people plus drama people that love drama, which most people do. Makes really a pretty bad situation for you, because, like, you can, like, hope something does not spread around, and it spreads around super duper quickly. So that's the thing I hate about drama and gossip. Like I remember one time, I overheard people talking about something, and it was crazy, and then we left to go to, like, our fourth period, and as soon as I came back to fifth period, everybody in the class was talking about it. I was, like, in a whole other class. I'm like, wait a minute, what? Like, two people knew, and, like, I heard people in the hallway talking about it. I'm like, what is going on here? Like, I will never understand how information about people, random old people, gets around so freaking fast. I would never understand that. Because, like, you really care about that person enough to be talking about them? Like, just saying, do they really matter that much to you? Because some people don't even know the people, they just like talking about people. I'm like, you know, you wouldn't like somebody to make, like, a whole gossip about you, right? No, you wouldn't. So, thank you guys for watching this video. If you guys did enjoy, make sure to leave a like down below and subscribe. If you guys want to become a mini preacher today, make sure to do all the stuff I just said. So, in conclusion, avoid drama, guys, as much as you can. It's not good for you. It really isn't. Because once you get, it's like a spider web. Once you get yourself tangled, it's hard to get out. And you could get yourself eaten by a spider. I don't know about that last part, but the other part may be true. See you guys next video. Bye.